Jerusalem. And end this disgrace. Let us rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. And end this disgrace.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Who could have said this in the Bible? Can I see somebody who wants to tell me? Who could have said this? What are the Bible scholars here? Who could have said this?
Let us rebuild the walls of Jerusalem to end this disgrace.
Do you have anyone?
Now, you see? Do you have
anyone? Who could have said this?
Nandi nyana wamba isu situ na.
Testament. That's Nehemiah. Let me explain this. Nehemiah was in captivity. He was one of those who were taken from their country to a foreign country. Now when he was there, he became very famous. Now he worked in the palace. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Very close to the king. So he was enjoying. But in captivity. But he had everything. But in captivity. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Wow, so it means you can enjoy while you are in captivity.
We have got people who are rich, but in captivity. Rich as they are, but in captivity. Hallelujah. Now, one day, this man met some people who were from Jerusalem. He said,
Arikabo,
how is it like in Jerusalem? Nehemiah knew the original Jerusalem. He knew the walls and the gates of Jerusalem. He knew how big Jerusalem was. Now he asked these people, how is Jerusalem? Jerusalem,
Jerusalem, if I forget you. He did not allow himself to forget about Jerusalem.
Now the answer was, the gates,
my gates,
and the walls,
Nadimbo,
had fallen down.
So,
burnt by fire. By the enemies who conquered Jerusalem. This man, who was in captivity, working in the palace, enjoying in the palace, but got worried. This information. It was this information wasn't told to him alone. It was told to many other people. But they never said anything about it. This time, Nehemiah got the information. information.
Mafungo asika kha Nehemia.
And he was troubled in his spirit.
Abaisala nga manda muyani.
I wonder.
Muti ndamvimba kuti kudzisa.
Those other people who had this information.
Ava vhanwe vhathu vhanzhi vhanzhi vha wana vhutanzi uvhu.
And never acted upon it.
Vasi ite chitungaho.
They never cared about it.
Vasi vhe na ndava naho.
And they were suffering.
Na huna uri vhone vhane vha vha khou tambula.
But this man,
hoyu munna hoyu,
who was better off than them,
we a vha khou tshila zwavhuḓi vha fhira vhone,
had this information.
Abva haya mafhungo matshi.
And he was troubled in his heart.
Fhedzi ene a vho vhaisa mbiluni.
As he went to the king,
musi a tshi kha khosi,
the king said,
khosi ya ri khae,
Nehemiah, I know you very well.
Ah, iwe Nehemiah ndi u ḓivha nda u fhedza.
You are worried about something.
Huna tshiṅwe tshithu tshi no khou vhaisa mbilu.
Even though you are trying your best,
ṋamusi ndi khou vhona u khou lingedza u mamwela
to portray happiness,
u tshi khou sumbedza u nga wo takala.
But I can see,
fhedziha ndi khou zwi vhona,
there is something that is troubling you,
uri huna tshiṅwe tshithu tshine tsha khou vhaisa.
Hallelujah,
praise the Lord.
And Nehemiah said, yes my king.
Nehemiah ati anda ri,
how can I enjoy,
na ndi ḓifhelwa hani,
when the walls of Jerusalem and the gates of Jerusalem are down,
musi dzimbondo na magete a Yerusalema zowa.
How can I enjoy,
ndi pfa hani mudifo,
when the original Jerusalem is destroyed,
musi Yerusalema ḽa u thomani ḽine nda ḽi ḓivha ḽi maḓuvha.
I have seen men and women,
muḓimba muḓimu vhona vhona vhanna na vhafumakadzi
enjoying,
vha tshi khou ḓiphi,
when the walls of protection in their houses are low,
hu na uri dzimbondo dzo tsireledza miṱani yavho ndi maḓumba dzowa. Jesus,
enjoying,
vha tshi khou ḓifhelwa.
When you can be wished,
hu na uri vhakona na u loiwa zwavhuḓi vhone vha tou lowea simple.
Enjoying,
vhone vha tshi khou ḓifhelwa.
When you cannot even wake up and pray,
vha tshi tou bva vha vuwa vha ita thabelo.
Enjoying,
vha ḓifhelwa.
When you cannot even know when you last read the scriptures,
vha sa ḓivhi na uri vho guma lini u vhala Bibiḽi.
The walls of your Jerusalem are down,
dzimbondo dza Yerusalema ḽa u
zowa. Yet you are living every day as if you are protected.
Fhedzi ya vhone na musi vha tshi tshimbila vha tshimbila sa muthu.
Of Jerusalem are down.
Una uri dzimbondo dza Yerusalem dzavho dzowa.
This man said, I will never rejoice.
Hoyu munna ari ndi nga si kone u
pfa ndi. I will never laugh.
Ndi nga si kone u sea.
I will never eat.
Ndi nga si kone u ḽa
tshena. Walls of Jerusalem are down.
Musi dzimbondo dza Yerusalem dzavho kwashaya dzi maḓumba. Praise the Lord.
Your Jerusalem is in ruins.
Vhone Yerusalema ḽavho ndi maḓumba.
You can't even pray.
Vha tou bvela no lavhela vhone.
You have conformed to the standard of this world.
Vhone vha khou tshimbila nga nḓila dza vhathu vha ḽino shango.
You are on Facebook and Twitter and everything like never before.
Vhone vha kha Facebook na Twitter ungari vha hone.
But you are never in the scriptures.
Mara a huna na ḓuvha na ḽithihi ḽine vha ḓiwana vha tshi khou vhala maṅwalo.
You support all those people who are saying their nonsense is there.
Vha tikedza zwithu zwoṱhe zwine ambiwa nga vhathu zwo bvaho.
And yet you call yourself a Christian.
Uno nga vha tshi tshimbila vha ri nṋe ndi mu Christ.
What type of a Christian is this one?
Nṋe ndi mu Christ ndi asa vha ri no rabela sa rabeli.
The world is confronted with this situation.
Li fhasi ke li lo li vha na nzulele hey.
Mudzimu ri vhathu vhanga.
And God says my people.
Vha na vhiswa nga tsika la.
Who are called by my name.
Arali vha tshi ṱoḓi kuyedza.
If they humble themselves.
Vha na ndila mbidza.
And forget their wicked ways.
This over funding gate
that I will hear them from heaven.
Na posta shango la.
And heal their land.
But listen.
Fhedzi kha vhathu hapa.
When the Israelites and the Philistines were fighting.
Musi vha Israelites na vha Philistines vha tshi khou lwa.
It took weeks.
Zwo dzhia dzivhele.
If not months.
Arali hu si miṅwedzi.
Until a certain young boy
usikana muwe muthanga
stepped into the space
achito sika ajena imaphanda havo.
The Israelite army was this side.
Oba una mbia ba Israelite yo imanga angeno.
The Philistine that side.
Ba Philistine na bone bo imanga angeno.
No one from Israel.
Usina na muthi yo no vaka la Israel.
They stood up.
Where are no linga no takwa abo.
And said, God use me to fight this Goliath.
Ali mudzimu shumisa nne likunde hoi Goliath.
God works with people.
Mudzimu ushuma nga kha vhathu.
Only those who stand up and get into the gap.
Ushuma nga vhene vhala vhane vha takuwa vha dzhena kha ḽivhaka ḽo sala uka.
You can be a Christian.
Vhane vha nga vha mu Christ.
Spirit filled.
Vha ḓala muya wa mudzimu.
Going.
Vha tshi khou ya ṱhaḓuni.
If you don't step into the gap. never use you. If you want God to use you, you need to step up from the rest. Step into the gap. And say, God, here I am. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Today,
Namusi.
Christians are not worried. When they hear that the walls of Jerusalem have fallen. I was watching a certain service. When we were still worshiping here. And the church was full. And I looked. People were sitting close to one another like this. And I said, today, we are told to make sure there is 1.5 space in the in between. I said, Lord, Jerusalem was not like this. The walls of Jerusalem have fallen. The walls of South Africa have fallen. The walls of Africa have fallen. The walls of the world have fallen. How can I eat? How can I celebrate? What type of Christmas is this? What type of a new year is this? How can I celebrate?
What
the walls of the country
are falling?
This year I'm not celebrating anything. God has protected me, yes. God has protected us, yes. But I don't have something to celebrate for. I'm in a fighting mood. I want to step into the space and say, Lord, I'm one of those who want to be used. I'm one of those who want to go for
battle.
The case about Jerusalem was reported to many. Who never cared? It was business as usual. Amen. I'm saying it was business as usual. Until this man got worried in his heart. He said, yes, I've got a position. But how can I celebrate?
Alone.
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 Alone. approval from others. And then they drag you down. You want to pray with others. They will tell you when to pray and when not to pray. You will only pray when they feel like praying. If you don't feel like praying, you will never sit down. This man took it upon himself. He said, I will do it alone. I will go there alone. I will fight alone. For I know how to deliver. I'm not alone. He went there. The Bible says,
Bibiliri,
3 days when he was in Jerusalem, he woke up in the night. He woke up in the night. You see, you will never achieve something if you cannot even wake up in the night and inspect the problems.
Yeah.
This man woke in the night. He inspected the problem.
Comes with everyone who knocked off late.
It did not take everyone.
Some
of your friends are your destroyers. And after destroying they come
in.
Amen. Amen.
The problem that is bothering you now
is from one of your friends.
You went and shared just a few. And then he came and stood with you. And he knew very well that those with whom he shared the information, they'll come and deal with you. Every day he's taking the message to your adversaries.
This man,
oh, you will know,
just a few. You will never do anything that pleases the Lord with a group of people. You will never. Amen. I say you will never. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Then he allotted them different spaces.
Because
he knew the problem.
Amen. When they started working, now Sanballat and Tobiah, they started attacking them. Now listen. Every time you stand up, do something for the Lord. Somebody will stand up and bring you down. There is in no way. No one has ever done anything for the Lord. And escape attacks. You are not prone to the attacks will come. Now if you face them, you will defeat them. If you succumb, it is your own leader. But make no mistake.
Not even a single man who took a step to do the things of God. None of them took ever took that step without any criticism.
Imagine.
If the apostle were to hear what they gossip about him and he sits down and forget about it, this church would have closed a long time ago. You would have come here and they say, the apostle has given up.
But when I went up, I built the wall of this church.
With the very rocks that you throw at him, he's building the walls.
Amen. Praise
the Lord.
If we are not able to battle in
coming
back. 7 in the morning. I'll be going to work. Three o'clock, I'll be coming back. I'll be going to my farm. 6 o'clock, I'll come back home. 10 o'clock, I'm going up the mountain. And I was doing that alone. So when I take the decision to go, and those prayers gave to this church. They gave hope to this church. Now, approval prayers will destroy you. When you realize that the walls of Jerusalem is fallen, stand up alone. If there are those who want to join you, don't join you. If there is no problem, you don't need the approval of any person. What you need is God himself. And Sanballat and Tobiah said, what do you think you're doing? And the wall that you're building, even if a fox jumps on it, they will fall. You are wasting your time. You don't even know how to build. What do you think you are doing at that little church? These are messages from those who once fellowshiped with us and they ran away because of witchcraft. Nobody chased them away but their witchcraft. And they realized that we can't function in this church. There's too much fire. Don't you see? That's the reason why we left. There's nothing you are doing there. Nothing at all. You are wasting your time. Look at that little apostle. And that little senior pastor. Those young boys. Once you hear somebody referring to a 58-year-old as a small boy, that's not, this person is bewitched beyond belief. They are bewitched, it cannot be reversed.
Can I be a boy of 58 years old?
No, I'm talking about 58 years.
The boy?
Aye.
You don't know what you're talking about, don't you?
Then you must know that this person is bewitched. That is the first sign to show that this person is sick in the mind. They need deliverance. And we have deliverance in this church.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Stand up alone. Stand up alone. The walls of Jerusalem are down.
You can't even sit next to each other. You can't even share the Bible. You can't even talk to your neighbor in the church.
Look how far you are. This is a sign that Jerusalem is no longer the same.
Do you want us to play for you next week the videos of this church previously? How filled this church would be? There are Christians who today are at home, they are shivering in fear.
Now Corona is their Bible.
They
are shaking.
Once a fly land on you,
Corona.
It brought me coronavirus.
Give me that old time religion. Give me that old time religion. Give me that old
old time religion, give me that old time religion.
Those who, when confronted with a situation, they stood up and they faced the situation head on in prayer. We are lukewarm Christians, they're always complaining once, waiting for the best situation. You may have heard that the government is saying by January, lockdown may be back in full force. Now, Wakai wa tendi. Wakai wa made.
Who will secretively?
About Mosi Pirin.
Hibernate.
About Samae.
The hibernation is a process whereby certain animals disappear for a period. Like snakes in winter, you don't find them. They're hibernated. You'll find them when it's warm. Where are Christians who are able to hibernate and pray for the world? Pray for our country. Pray for the church. I invite you. Let's hibernate for the sake of our country, for the sake of our people. I'm not saying we mustn't observe the protocol.
No.
We must observe them fully and more than that of foot. But let's hibernate and go straight to God and say, God, the walls of Jerusalem have come
down.
Jerusalem, I
chaffer.
We know our Jerusalem. But this church cannot be solved if the world is not solved. If South Africa is not solved. If we solve the world, if we solve the world in prayer, South Africa is resolved. And the church also is solved. Join me. As we hibernate in prayer and face this pandemic head on. And see if we do not have God. I've seen God changing things. I'm telling the truth. I've seen God changing things. But what I've realized is that we are so crowded with things. But we cannot even pray. Our prayers are too few.
He says what he was referring to earlier about his prayer life. He was not a pastor then.
It means my head was less crowded. Now the sooner I ignore you,
zvino musi muapostola vaito dzia cheo yori vakaubva kha matanda avo vori na zvichere zvavo,
and go to God,
vambodiriva kha mudzimu,
the better for this church.
Zviva zvikwine zvichiterwa hi kereke.
The sooner I ignore you and your problems,
arali
vafuna vanga ro tavanya vabva kha vone na zvikotopora zvavo na mathada avo na dzithaidzo dzavo.
And they just pray for you.
Vatorabhera vone fedzi vasakuvachecheresa.
The better for this church.
Izvozvo zvokwine kha ikereke.
Vangazvipfesha.
You will not understand this.
Deep in your nation.
It's a bit deep.
The one who are not praying
for you. He would have prayed for you so much, but in private. Having ignored your problems, your challenges, and your
squabbles.
At that time, we have joined him as the church. We are moving together with him.
Be prepared.
Kaba dingiselo chimira maja na
mawosko. We want to hibernate.
Usi kare record tumba.
Be prepared.
Kaba do dilugisela.
We want to hibernate.
Usi kare yo tumba.
In prayer.
Riko tumba matapelo.
We want to face the enemy head on.
Riko todo do livana na swina na zipatu.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
May you be blessed.
Wane wo patuchetwa.
May you be protected.
Wane wo tireretwa.
In the name of Jesus.
Atina la Yeso.
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 Blessed coming in.
Wana wachezo wachiva.
Blessed going out.
Wachezo wachichena.
In the name of Jesus.
Atina la Yeso.
Blessings are yours.
Wachezo dzawo.
Protection is yours.
Kana zodiabo.
In the name of Jesus.
Atina la Yeso.
Protection is yours.
Uso diabo.
In the name of Jesus.
Atina la Yeso.
It's well with you.
Zabo zoruga.
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 In Jesus' name.
Katina la Yesu.
Amen and amen.
Amen.